We all know the atomic bomb is very dangerous. Since it may be used against us, we must get ready for it. Just as we are ready for many other dangers, fire is a danger. It can burn whole buildings if someone is careless. It can burn whole buildings if someone is careless. It can burn whole buildings if someone is careless. It can burn whole buildings if someone is careless. It can burn whole buildings if someone is careless. It can burn whole buildings so you know what to do. It can burn whole buildings if someone is careless. It can burn whole buildings if someone is careless. It can burn whole buildings when we are ready for fire, since it may be used against us if someone is careless. And you have fire drills in your school. We have a fine fire department to put out the fire. And you have fire drills in your school. So you know what to do if someone is careless. And you have fire drills in your school. We have a fine fire department to put out the fire. And you have fire drills in your school. So you know what to do if someone is careless. Automobiles can be dangerous too. If someone is careless, they sometimes cause bad acts. If someone is careless, we are ready. If someone is careless, we have safety rules now. If someone is careless, automobiles can be dangerous too. If someone is careless, they sometimes cause bad acts. If someone is careless, we are ready. Someone is careless. We must be ready for a new danger. The atomic bomb. The atomic bomb. It can burn whole buildings. The atomic bomb.
Good evening, everybody. How is everyone doing on this fine, fine November the 1st? You guys doing good? You guys doing great? You guys doing other synonyms for good?
Oh my God, everyone's going in with the subs already. I haven't even started. Wait, there's no notifications. Wait, it's still the Hack Takeover. Give me a moment. But how's everyone doing today? You guys holding up well? Thank you, Epic, for all the subs. I appreciate it. Thaf, I already filled in that November. I don't know why you wanted to broadcast to everybody who's watching this right now that you failed it, but so be it. If you fail it, you fail it. But, you guys are probably wondering what we're doing today. And what we're doing today is we're going to return to our React Andy roots. And we're going to go and watch some scary stuff today. Because there's a lot of scary stuff that we're going to be watching. Well, I'd say a lot of scary stuff. We're going to do a big fat recap. Because I kind of want the stream to be a big recap of everything. Like, because right now, if you guys don't know already by the title of the stream and the video, we will be going through the whole of Local 58 once again, and we are going to be live reacting pretty much to everything about Local 58 and all of the ARG stuff that's happened in between, because there's been a lot of ARG stuff that's happened over the past couple of days. But before I go into Local 58 and everything, I need to say hi to you guys, because it's been a while. Let's glitch into it. Hello. How are you guys? How are you guys holding up today? I have not seen this bedroom for a while. You've not seen this. We're being wavy already? Oh, I guess so. Let's be wavy already. Yeah. There we go. There the subs coming in. All right. Anyway, you guys are probably wave the glitch. I can't wave the glitch. I can just show you this. Hi. But wait, you're still keeping Hack if it's October? Listen, it's not over until I say it's over. It's not, wait, are we getting scanned already? And we're going purple! Ah! Why are your hands so thin, bro? I don't know! But thank you guys for all the subs so far. Thank you, Sentinel, for the 100 bits. Thank you, Floral, for subscribing with Prime. Thank you, Pugsley, for the 3 months. Thank you, Epic Psychiatric, for gifting the 5. Thank you, God of Mercy, for the 2 months. Thank you, Precision Gamer, for the 3 months.
It's this long already.
And thank you, Louis, for subbing for the 8 months. Yeah, no, Hacktober isn't over until I say it's over. Until I say it's over.
Hello.
Like, until I say it's over, Hacktober's not over yet. It might be November, but October won't be over just yet. So yes, I'm going to stay for a little while longer. But anyway, You guys probably are expecting me to get straight into it, so let's not waste too much time. I bet everyone's gonna be like, why aren't you laughing at this? Why aren't you gonna laugh at this one? I got my laughs out already. We're watching something that's actually good from the get-go. So, thank you, Royal Talipa, for the sub. So, I guess without further ado, we're gonna go and go straight into what we're going to be doing today. And it is in the middle of the screen, and it is Local 58. Can we get some pug in the chat for Local 58? We're back, and we're watching scary stuff again. Chucky. Like, we're getting serious. I bet people in the comments are gonna be like, I'm not gonna watch this. You're just gonna laugh at it all the time. I'm like, I laugh at stuff that I find funny. I don't find things scary anymore. Everyone's like, why aren't you taking this one seriously? Why aren't you taking that one seriously? Well, to that I say, do I want? I've been doing this from the get-go. It's like you expected me to take something seriously when I've never taken anything seriously on Thaf, VODS, or T9. So no. In fact, I'm gonna spell it out. I will take it. I'll take it.
YouTube TV show Mentally Scars Glow Stick Man / J.
Maybe, but I will take it as seriously as I need to take it, because there's a difference between faking getting scared and faking laughing. Everyone's like, oh, it's not that funny, bro. I found it hilarious. I find scary videos hilarious all the time, because it's the our only method of just like taking things apart. But anyway, we've been stalling for way too long, and I wanted to begin by not showing you the latest Local 58 video just yet. I am on Local 58's website right now, but I won't be showing you the latest Local 58 video just yet. We're going to do a bit of a recap. We're going to do a recap so that people can jog their memory as to Local 58 in general and where everything is at so far. So because of that, this is going to be the definitive Local 58 video.
Hello, motherfucker.
Thank you, Jed, for the 15 months. But yeah, I'm going to go from the very beginning. We're going to catch up on everything. And then we're going to go over the ARG for the latest one and then try and solve it on stream and everything with what we know already. Like, I was up until 5 a.m. last night trying to solve the ARG. So, I guess we're just gonna go through with it and chat. Get out your notebooks, chat. I want you guys to get out your notebooks and turn to page 57, because we're going to start this deep dive and it's going to be amazing. Make sure you take notes. Take notes. I'll be asking you questions after this. I will be asking you questions after this. After the Local 58 catch up. Anyway, let's go on to Local 58's channel, and the best course of action is to start from the top. Let's start from the top, from the very beginning. In fact, let's go to playlist. Let's just go watch all of them. But in terms of doing it from front to back, we're gonna do it back to front. So it's gonna be kind of weird. I wish I could change the order of how this is going. But anyway, let's begin with the first one. You are on the fastest available route. Tour 5 a.m., the midnight movie, 1:55 a.m. I like the music. The music's like a good way to start it off. Oh! Well, we begin.
Proceed to the highlighted route.
Continue
on Holbrook Park Drive. Then in 500 feet, turn right onto North 38th Street. You will arrive at your destination in 2 hours and 28 minutes.
2 hours and 28 minutes? Interesting. Okay, so the first thing is that we need to pay close attention to some of the details in this specific episode. Like, we have to pay a lot of close attention to the details, like dates and times and everything. So just chat. Make a mental note of all the dates that show up throughout the Local 58 viewing experience. So like right now, the 21st of November 2014 is the date for this recording. Also, I find it interesting how we don't know what sat nav they're using. Like, what form of sat nav could this guy be using to lead him to like such a sus area. Also, is it this will be dash cam footage in 2015. Thaf, can we stop at McDonald's? I'm hungry. No! You could have had your food an hour ago. Parkway.
You are on the fastest available route.
I find it hilarious that like, how long was that time shift?
Turn left onto Merritt Parkway, then take the on ramp to Highway 114 North.
The thing is, I love how it's absolutely pissing it down. Like, it's absolutely, completely and utterly pissing it down. This is not
10 miles, take exit 17, then turn right onto Quarry Utility Road South.
Like, oh my god, the weather is really, really, really bad. I'm kind of interested though if there was like anything here that would have been on a note. It's like everyone's like, this is the USA now, this is the UK.
You are on the fastest route.
I mean, if we're on the fastest route, but the thing is, where were we going? That's all I never understood about this first short. Where exactly were we going? Because we seem to be going to the middle of nowhere. We're in nowhere middle of.
Right to stay on service causeway H516. You will arrive at your destination in 14 minutes.
14 minutes, so it's 4:48 right now, which means... Oh, so the destination's been arrived at. I never understood though, like with this one, I guess it's a rogue sat nav, but where were we actually going? If we're on the fastest available route or something, where were we going?
Make a U-turn.
Make a U-turn.
Head east for 1/4 of a mile. Then follow signs for do not enter.
I love this. Follow signs, but do not enter. Why are we blindly following the sat nav unless we're supposed to like? Unless the guy wanted to die. Like, I feel like he had a death wish. Like he wanted
continue
to die.
On unnamed road. Then, in 300 feet, turn off your headlight.
Like, why would you want to do that? Why would you actually want to do that? Turn off your headlights. For what purpose? Why are we going to listen to the... Like, honestly, what are we supposed to do? What are we supposed to do? It's like, you go through all of that and then your sat nav tells you to turn off your headlights and go to the middle of the forest. Like, come on. And then he just waits. And all of a sudden, like a monster. Ah! Oh no, now we're driving. Ah! Run! Drive! I'm driving. Oh no. Oh no, he's getting close. Oh, he's getting close. Ah!
You have arrived.
All right. We're back. I mean, we kind of, I guess we died, but that's the, but I'm going to look back. Was that not fire just then? Like, did our car just like burst into flames? Hang on. That looks like fire. Is that arson moment? Like, look over there. Did our car like burst into flames as well? Or did we get sent flying out? Okay, so I wanted to look closer just to see if there was anything like frame by frame. But yeah, that's the first one. You are on the fastest available route. What do we guys think of that one? Out of 10, what do we think of that one? What are we saying? 3 out of 10, 10 out of 10. I honestly think, in terms of a short, that was really good. Because you don't see the monster. Like, I think that's a good way to start it off. But yeah, that was You Are on the Fastest Available Route, We are now going to go over to the next one on the list, and it was contingency. Contingency was the next one on the list. So let's just go straight into it. I think this is where the story starts taking a turn. This is when like the story kind of starts taking shape, I guess. And we got a new logo. Up next, 3 a.m. end of broadcast day. And then the music just stops. Well, concludes our broad salute. I'm trying to salute. Yes. I'm not even American. Why am I doing this? All right. Yeah, have a great night. Wait, what? Oh, U.S. Department for the Preservation of American Dignity. The Preservation of American Dignity. Sorry, it's just like, we got to preserve the dignity in our nation. Oh, gosh. Have a nice night. Now die for your country. Also, again, I must reiterate that I have, or like most of the people in this chat, myself included, have seen this multiple times. I've seen Local 58 multiple times. So this is just like an experience with the chat as we get into the new one. Just wanted to clarify to people who are probably watching this on the VODS channel or watching this on Twitch after I'm streaming this. But anyway, do not use after the 13th of November, 1970. I've just noticed that this is the second time in a row that we've gone for November, but this time it's 1970. Contingency message reel. Locator USDFPAD 393H15A to be used only in the event of United States complete surrender to insurmountable enemy forces. Public broadcast only upon confirmed condition 12 Omaha solemn certainty. I mean, it's November right now, so it kind of makes sense. Like, we're doing this right here, right now. Anyway, contingency message will now begin. Please comply with the following instructions. God bless America. See, the thing is, I don't gotta care about this because I'm British. Like, I don't care about it. Anyway, the worst has come to pass. Despite the sacrifices of our citizens and the might of our armed forces, the United States has been forced to surrender to her enemy. Though they may occupy our borders, our streets, and our homes, the enemy will never occupy our spirit. This is why all Americans are now called upon to act, to preserve the memory of the United States clear and bright, untarnished, and uncompromised. See, we don't know what the insurmountable enemy forces is as well. Like, the only time they'd show something like this if something absolutely terrible happened. And the only way something absolutely terrible happens, aliens. It's aliens. It's literally Independence Day all over again. That's the only way to explain any of this happening. Know that I have already taken action in the company of family and loved ones. Now all Americans, every man, woman, and child are called upon to act before the moment passes by. Let our united resolve echo through history. Even in defeat, we refuse to yield. Even in defeat, we claim victory. That doesn't make sense. Even in defeat, we claim victory. Doesn't that make you a sore loser? It's like, I lost, but I won. It's like, you literally, you fair and square lose 3-0. And you're just like, I won, but I won in the hearts and minds of the people. It's basically copium. It's basically English, us English, like the England national team during the Euros. We may have lost the final, but we won the spirit of the nation. And that's what matters. And the letters, this is signed by Lyndon B. Johnson, which means, we'll continue. That's the letter to everyone. So what is the act? How do we act? The president of the signature of that one's Lyndon Johnson. Act immediately. Honor liberty by taking the final and greatest liberty of all. It's a privilege to be called to action. You take America with you. I do find it interesting that contingency basically, it plays on like American, is it patriotism? I was going to say imperialism, but this is more of a patriotism. Like, cause you can imagine the kind of people that would probably have seen this, like the people that would have seen this, a lot of people that actually done it. Well, you know, why is it doing God Save the Queen? I'm only joking. Anyway, we will each be remembered. Use the method most available to you at this time. Your courage will inspire others. There's nothing to fear. I wonder. The time has come. Access to a loaded firearm is ideal. Place muzzle hold. Wait, whoa. Go back. Place muzzle hole of gun upward to roof of mouth. Thank you. That's a nice way to go about it. It's like, oh yeah, the time has come. Can you please, would you kindly get a gun and get the muzzle? It's the roof of the mouth. It's the roof of the roof of mouth and the hole of the gun. Just stick it right up there and then pull the trigger. Thank you. Now join your neighbors, your family, your God. Wait, what was that? What was that? Sorry. What was that? What was that? Before I go there, your country needs you to say goodbye with pride. So it's basically like a mass, yeah, it's a contingency. I know there'd been the theories already. I'm kind of doing this off the top of my head from what I remember, because I didn't prepare like a proper analysis kind of pack for contingency, but it's essentially just telling everyone to kill themselves for America. As a citizen, you must act now. Your local law enforcement has been ordered to ensure your compliance. It's against the law to delay. This message will repeat until there are none to read it. And this is implying that the president did this already. Like, it's implying that the president already did this. Remember the victory position. The three Fs, front lawn, face up, feet together. Regarding your children, tend to them before yourself. Use a calm tone of voice. Everyone can do their part. Oh, damn. Oh my God. It's like they've literally... Whoa, I saw that. The 51st state is not a place. Interesting. But what else did it say? It said something really quickly before... Infants and pets, the smallest patriots. Jeez. Oh my God. Infants and... That's kind of like... I just realized, you know how mental that is as well? This is why I like local... I like Local 58 the most out of all of them, because it's like... It's so ominous and creepy. That's why I like it. It's like a broadcast message that you don't know what the insurmountable enemy forces are. But all you know is that this has suddenly taken over the broadcast at like 3 a.m. in the morning, like an emergency alert system, and it's telling people, oh yeah, so the president, I kind of already did this already. If it's like, if you're reading this message, that means I am dead. And you should join me. Get your guns, get your shotguns, get anything. Face up, on the lawn, feet together, gun on the roof of your mouth, get the muzzle, pull the trigger, and then Bob's your uncle. And all of a sudden, it just got... Technical difficulties, we apologize. We apologize for the interruption. It was just a prank, bro. It was just a prank. It was a punk. You just got punked. It was a prank, bro. Oopsie daisy. We made a little fucky wacky. Correct. Earlier today, this station aired what appeared to be a warning message from a U.S. government agency. This is confirmed to be a hoax. Local 58 apologizes for any confusion that may have resulted. So Local 58 did a bit of trolling, but look closely at the background. Look closely at the background. If you guys don't notice already, you can see the you can see another message here. And it says, well, from what I see, local 58 apology card locator. In the event of accidental public broadcast during something, power relays down before something else. Can you guys see that? It's a hoax application card. It's like, I think it's the possibility that Local 58 were like, this might have been legit. It might not have been a troll. It might have been legit. You guys can see it right there. Like, it's probably going to be lit up in a bit. There. Yeah, there we go. It's lit up properly. If I try and go back, there. Local 58, do not use after the 14th of May. Do not use after 14th of May, 1975. Local 58 hoax apology. And it says hoax apology card, like hoax. It's in quotation marks, meaning that it's like, maybe it's a cover up. The conspiracies. Maybe it's a cover up. And it wasn't actually a hoax. It's like a hoax. It's like, you know, it's like a hoax, that kind of thing. Don't do an Alex Jones. Well, I'm going to replace my hat with a tinfoil hat because this is definitely not a hoax. I think that the government is on to this something right here. Anyway, do not use after 31st or December 2016 contingency. And you've got a credit. So that was a contingency. But then you have to realize something. During this broadcast, people might have done this while it was being broadcast, because imagine it goes on for about, it's 3 a.m. in the morning. Some people are still, you know, watching and getting ready for bed and everything. Then all of a sudden, it just does this. Like this. And it shows this. And then you see this. And then it goes through the whole thing again. So like, cause this goes around about 2 minutes before people call it a hoax or anything. And if I recall correctly, this is the 1970s as well. You didn't have scrutiny of social media. You didn't have, like, if something like this happened, let's say for now, if the BBC made a public announcement and said, oh, insurmountable enemy forces, I need you to get a gun. Wait, no, you can't have guns in the UK. I need you to get your nearest butter knife and then spread it on your body and then lay out in the sun and then let it melt all over you and then pretend you're a slug or something like that. Like, you'd go to social media and just be like, what the fuck? Like, you'd do that on social media, like, instantly. But this is the 1970s that didn't have social media at the time. So people would have seen this and they would have just been like, what in the hell is this? Well, we're gonna have to do it. And it's just like, Bobby, get the shotgun. And then, yeah, the rest is history. But the idea that people would be watching at 3 a.m. and are still awake enough to follow through in the 1970s is a high expectation. That's true. Imagine, you just see that. It's like 3 a.m. in the morning and you're just like, what's this about? What's this about? Lyndon Johnson claimed victory. Did we just lose or something? What happened? Did we lose the Vietnam War? You take America with me. This looks cool. This is just great. Yeah, this is great. I'm really tired. Just, it's nice calming music. This music's really, really calm. I'm just gonna. Oh fuck! Oh god! Anything? Agnow? What do you mean front face long feet together? What am I doing? Well, what are we doing? Regarding children? It's basically like that. Oh, infant and pets? Oh, it's basically just that. Most people at 3 a.m. It's like realistic 3 a.m. behavior. Anyway, that was contingency. The next one is weather service. Weather service, I think, is the most interesting one out of all of them for now, because I think this is the one that pushes the story even further forward than it already has. Anyway. Whoa, what was that? Okay. So we already got a Local 58 logo, but I just realized some foreshadowing. There is some foreshadowing here. Look at the fact that says focus on faith. And you already know what the situation with the moon is. So I feel like that's some slight foreshadowing as to what's to come. So let's go for it. Anyway, music. Hey! Oh God! Weather warning. Okay. All right. It's happening. Oh my God! It's happening. Stay calm. All right, stay calm. All right, where we at? What we doing? The County Weather Service has issued a warning for a meteorological event. This warning is effective immediately and continues until sunrise tomorrow morning. And this one doesn't look like a hoax either. I'm just looking at this. This one doesn't look like a hoax either.
No way.
Yeah, no way indeed. Thank you, Spicy, for the 8 months. Local 58 is everything Gemini and Sim and all other analog horrors nowadays try to be. I mean, yeah. Also, can you hear something? Wait, I'm going to put the volume up. Can you hear this? It's very, very quiet. You guys hear speaking, right? It sounds like talking. I'm risking. Should we go consult the comments to see what people have said about the speaking? Or should we just like keep going? I feel like we should just keep going. I hear a voice. Wait, let me just listen closer. Sorry, it's really loud for me right now. Yeah, I can hear something. I'm trying to listen closely, but I don't hear much. Anyway, citizens are advised not to observe this event with the naked eye. Oh, here we go. All right. Well, that was random. It was like, and that was random. Was that a hoax or was it not? Like, explain to me what I just saw. You're gonna have to explain. Okay, yes, explain. What, a civil danger alert now? Oh no! The County Weather Service has issued the following correction for the weather warning in effect.
Wow, 5 months.
Thank you, Pastor Fiend, for the 5 months. All right, let me just see what it said again. For your safety, remain indoors. Do not look at the night sky. More information to follow. Also, this is real. Like they've clarified it to say even something even worse. Before it used to be like, oh yeah, you should probably not look at the sky. Now they're telling you, like, they're literally just telling you, don't look at the sky. Don't do it. Do not do it. The meteorological event is safe for all to view. Warning has been lifted. Has it? It looks like that had just been typed. So you know it's a debate. Like, you know it's a debate. Look, it had just been typed. Like, two entities are fighting. Oh, go outside now. Yeah, no, like two. I like how it's basically two people fight. It's like two people fighting over what they're telling people. It's like, you've got the entity from the moon that's telling people, go outside now, look at me, hey, it's like, hey, look at me. So he's just like really big, just towering over everyone, just going like, hey, look at me, look at me,
I'm really, really scary, I'm really scary, go touch the grass, come on, look at me, man, I'm right over here.
And like meanwhile the everyone else in the broadcasting studio, they're just like, what the fuck? What the fuck is going on? Who's doing this? Who's doing it? So it's literally that kind of panic. Anyway. If you can read this, all right. Do not look at them. Oh, I noticed that it's kind of shielded like what it says do not, because you can see, I don't know whether you can notice, it's very, very particular, but you can see O and a T. So this is obviously do not look at the moon. Do not look at the moon. Also, pay close attention to the details in this video. We will need this later. I just wanted to let you guys know real quick. Pay very close attention to the details in this specific video because we will need all of this later. Do not look at the moon. Like, don't do it. Stay inside. Don't look at the night sky. See, they're like fighting over control over the network. Face away from all windows. Avoid mirrors. Do not look up. You're not the boss of me! There's nothing there. The following is a message from the County Weather Service. It's in the light. Oh no. The moon came in. He found me. Me? Through the mirror? Found me through the mirror? He's for me? Moonlight white. White like eyes. Not light but blood. I drown in him. Who let the moon in? If you are afraid, we will look together. And there it is. Hang on. We're not supposed to be looking at the moon. Ah, look away, chat. Look away. Whoa. Okay, it's gone. When I still see it. But that was weather service. Okay, that was weather service. So in the battle between the moon versus the broadcasting studio, the moon ended up winning because it looks normal. It's normal again, but you can tell it's someone who's been indoctrinated by the moon. The moon is no longer a place. It's a living thing, yeah. Let's go start a moon cult. Yeah, that's also interesting. There's no date on this one. This one hasn't been dated. I think it is sometime between 2003 and 2011, though. That's why I'm saying it's definitely between 2003 and 2011. Yeah, but that was weather service. What do you rate that one out of 10? What do we rate that one out of 10? Seven. But there was a flash of 10 X's in a row. Hang on, let me go back. Like towards the end of this. Maybe this is something that will be. I wonder what this could mean. I wonder what this could mean. I think we're gonna get more information about that later. Later. We'll get more information about what the X's truly mean later. But yeah, it's a lot of adult material. It's a lot of porn. It's a lot of sex! 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 Anyway, the station ID. Next one's station ID. I like the ID, it's nice. Ah! Yes! We begin up, look away. Okay, I'll look on, you know, I'm not looking away. Now that is very important. That's actually very, very important. This station ID right here. This is the standard Local 58 logo, but this. There are other receivers. This statement's very important.
I smell of raw sex appeal.
Stop. All right. Now, it's very important. It's very important for it's very important that we make notes of the fact that it says there are other receivers. Other stations, yeah, there could be other stations just like Local 58. But yeah, I just make sure you keep that in the back of your mind because we're gonna get back into it later. Safety in numbers. And that's it. That was just the station ID. So no, we'll go straight to the next one. And the next one is Show for Children. The next one's Show for Children. So this one's actually my favorite one. So I guess let's just go straight into it. And there's a new logo. It's more modern. It looks more modernized. Like, that's what you can tell, that there's been a time skip because this one's got a more modernized intro than the other ones. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. But why would they show it? Okay, but that's the thing. Why would they actually show a show for children at 4:15 a.m. in the morning? That's like when teleshopping should be on. You should be showing QVC. We should be seeing like you selling some weird glass sculpture of a human, like a 6-foot human, but a glass sculpture. And you could see like the blood flowing around the body. That's the kind of stuff I should be seeing at 4 a.m. on TV. Yeah, Cartoon Network at night. We are, Lewis, you and I are both British. You do realize that Adult Swim is not in the UK on Cartoon Network. It's against the law. It is literally against the law for Adult Swim to show on Cartoon Network in the UK. Everyone's like, whack. That's why Adult Swim's on a different service. Everyone's asking why. It's again. Can you explain why? Oh, okay. Let's do a quick tangent. Very quick tangent about Adult Swim. So, in the UK, we have got a regulatory body that's helped with the government called Ofcom. There are rules set in place for how TV channels are classified in the UK. And we have different sections. Like when you go in the UK and you have the categories when you have cable TV. So for example, in the UK, we have documentaries, film, sports, and then there's a category called kids. This category is like children's channels and cartoon channels. So it goes to like Cartoon Network, Cartoon Network 2, Disney Channel, Nickelodeon, CBeebies, Disney XD, those kind of channels. Those are officially classified as kids channels in the UK. Now, because of that, Adult Swim is an adult, Adult Swim's an adult programming block. Because of that, Adult Swim is not allowed to operate on a kids TV channel even after the watershed. We have a thing in the UK called a watershed, which means that you're not allowed to show anything violent or anything with bad language. It has to be all family friendly until 9 p.m. It has to be family friendly until 9 p.m. Cartoon Network 2, the UK has two Cartoon Network channels. Funny thing about that one, Cartoon Network 2, which was CNTOO, was the British version of Toonami. Toonami wasn't, it was a separate channel, but no one watched it when it mattered. So they merged with Cartoon Network to become Cartoon Network 2. And then that got shut down as well. But basically we had, after 9 o'clock, you're allowed to show, you're allowed to show basically violent programs. So if you have like Game of Thrones, for example, is shown at like 9 p.m. That kind of stuff. That's the official watershed time. You'll get in trouble with the government and the TV regulatory bodies if you're broadcasting things like that, like before 9 p.m. But officially, Adult Swim is an adult channel. And it cannot be shown on any TV channel that's classified as a kids channel. In America, Adult Swim is on Cartoon Network as a block at night. Even at night, in the UK, we're not allowed to have Adult Swim. So by law, Adult Swim cannot operate on Cartoon Network. instead of that, it operates on our version of Channel 4. We had Channel 4 is basically like it's a public channel. And it's it has a bunch of, you know, TV shows and whatever. But Adult Swim has to show on that channel after 9 p.m. So we don't have the Cartoon Network crossovers and everything. Everything that's broadcast on Adult Swim is broadcast on 4. Like Channel 5, yeah, pretty much. So, yeah. That's basically why. It's a law that's in place. Because Cartoon Network is designated as a kids channel in the UK, meaning that Adult Swim, as an adult programming block, cannot operate even after 9 p.m. The watershed doesn't apply on kids channels. They are supposed to show family-friendly content the whole day. Why not just make a channel for Adult Swim? It's not cost-effective. Adult Swim channels cost a lot to run. It's not cost effective for time. Like, even then, like, the owners of Adult Swim, it used to be AT&T, now it's going to be Discovery. But even they don't want anything to do with Adult Swim. They've been wanting to, like, axe all the shows and sell half the stuff. So, yeah, it's not cost effective to have it as its own channel. So, yeah, the more you know. The more you know. If you guys want more trivia and everything, I'll be down to give you some fun trivia facts throughout the stream. But that's basically... But... To go back to Local 58, it's very interesting that they're broadcasting a TV show for children at 4:15 a.m. in the morning. But anyway, then what the adult anime shows that show on Cartoon Network after 10 to 12, or am I old, or as I forgot? Mad Brit. The adult anime that was shown on Cartoon Network was the 4Kids version. You notice how all of the anime that Cartoon Network showed and Nickelodeon showed was the 4Kids version, so it was already censored. That's why they flew on Cartoon Network. Because everyone's going to ask, how did One Piece broadcast on Cartoon Network? Because it was the 4Kids version. You know, the one with like the yeah, yo, no, that one. Anyway, yeah. Also, you don't need to apologize, Mad Brit. It's a good point to make because I knew someone was going to bring up, why do they have all these, why do they have like, I don't know, Helsing or something? It's because it's this fucking 4Kids version. Anyway, back to Local 58. You are watching Local 58. I hated this. The first time I saw that, I hated that. Like, look at his big mouth. Look at his big ass mouth. Look at his big mouth. Like, the clown's literally Omega lolling. Like, the clown's literally doing Omega lol IRL. Like, how do you manage to Omega lol IRL? But anyway, I love how, like, imagine just going to, imagine you just go to, like, watch it, and then this shows at the end, Omega clowning. All right. Also, fun thing about Cadaver is actually, it was a running comic that Chris Straub had before the, before like the development of Local 58. So you could see other stuff that Chris did with Cadaver, but yeah, it's like the first animated outing for him. He's French. Okay, let's go and dissect this frame by frame. Well, mostly frame by frame. What you got, you guys got to look at a couple of things. First and foremost, make sure you pay attention to the moon's location. Pay attention to the background, pay attention to the tree, and then pay attention to Cadaver. Hey, look, it's Richard. It's like, hey guys, it's Richard! Now the first one, it goes right through the tree. Oh no, there's Coochie in there! Yeah! There's Coochie in there! Show! Yes! Yeah, show me! It's like, show me the goods! Okay, show me the... Oh my god! Damn! Damn, he's doing that thing. See, I remember people in the Mandela catalog like bitching and complaining about this. I'm just like, yeah, no, he's doing that anime thing. I'd fuck it. Sorry, I was trying to look to find who asked. Oh, and he's going to, he got scared. And now he has to do it again. And now he's a bit more scared than the last time. But the thing is, I thought about it, but why does Cadaver keep coming back to the same place? Unless he's gotten himself lost. Like, he's doing it again. And then this time something else shows up. Ew! What the hell? Ew! And it makes like a cat noise as well. I never liked that. I was like, ugh. What actually is that? Like, bro, what the bird doing? Why is the bird making a mewling sound? It's like a baby. Is that a Metroid enemy? Okay, now the first change. Look at the moon. The moon's not happy now. He's just staring. Also, look. One important thing to note. Look at the moon. It goes over the scan for the wood. Monsters are knocked over, but like, look very closely. It's something that I wanted to like make sure people notice when they watch this. The moon, like on the previous versions of this, not only did the moon have the tree had branches, but the moon is very clearly behind the branches and it's in the sky, like far away. But some people can call it a layering error, but I genuinely think this was intentional. I do think this was intentional because it suddenly changed and it very obviously shows it over. Like over the branch. And there's no like proper branch as well. It's literally just a thing. And this is the third attempt, right? This was like Cadaver's attempt number three. I don't think that's an error. So he goes there and he goes there, but like, why does he keep going to that grave? And now there's nothing there. It's just a cave. It's just nothing. And now we're going in. Why are we going in? Why are we going into the cave? Now I thought that the moon was here, but apparently it's not here yet. He wants that scussy. Shut up, please. Please stop. Was that the moon in the background? Oh, and he's doing the victory position. Like, look at him. He's literally doing the victory position. So yeah, he's got insurmountable enemy forces. And there's nothing there. This is a grave underneath. And then the moon arrives. Like, how did the moon get over there? Look at this, and now Cadaver's dead. But what happened? Did the moon kill Cadaver, or did he kill himself? Like, he died. Like it's not even that. Like he died. Because the thing is, the victory position, from what I recall, the victory position, you do that and then you kill yourself. The motherfucker's already dead. No, but he's dead. Like he is dead. He's double dead. He's double negative. His feet aren't together, but he's face up, and it's like he's looking up at nothing. Yeah, maybe this was his victory. He finally escaped France. And then the moon arrives. And then he's dead. And that's it. Now this. Did you guys notice that? I kind of been the only one that noticed that. Some YouTubers didn't cover this, but you notice how the clowns are mega lulling harder. The clown's mouth is so much bigger than before, and the eyes move. Like if you look closely, look, the eyes move to start looking at you. Like there. You know, it's like a different render. The eyes start moving. Like, look closely. I'm doing it frame by frame. Frame by frame. The eyes start, like, slowly looking towards you. Like, it twitches. It'll be faster in motion if I do it like this. Watch. You can see it there. I'm 99% sure that's the same clown. Because, like, there. And then... there. It's the same. It's literally the same. Like it literally is the same. It's just that look. It's so much more saturated. It's so much more saturated, and the mouth is so much bigger. It's. Because why does it look? Oh my god, did you really use Shoop the Whoop? Did you really bring back firing my laser just because of the red lips? Honestly, that would have been funny. Imagine if someone just like edited the video and just added a laser like at the end of it. But yeah, look. It's exactly the same, but the saturation's higher. The clown looks like an NFT. It looks like one of those ugly ape NFT. Oh my god, now I can't unsee it. I hate you. I hate you so much, I can't unsee it now. I can't unsee it. But yeah, no, it's right. So if we go back there. Yeah, that, but so essentially, we now know that I guess there's a common enemy in Local 58, and that enemy is the moon. The common enemy is the moon. All right, next one, a look back. We've got three more. Next one's a look back. So we've got a Local 58 logo. We've got different Local 58 like era logos. We haven't seen this one. And also, this tagline is really, really ominous. Like, I'm not a big fan of this ominous tagline, "We've always been here." That kind of insinuates that there's something, like, they're in league with, like, whatever the moon's planning. So that's a look. Whoa, what was that? What was that? Oh, that was just a glitch, standard glitch. All right, what? What now? We send signals to ourselves through their domain. Did we really believe they wouldn't add their own? That's interesting. And now contingency shows up again. Wait, what's that? Whoa, 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 Whoa. What was that? What is this? But that blood's going up. I don't think that's blood. It could be corruption. I don't think that's blood. Imagine it's just shit. Someone like clogged up the toilet. Someone shat on the floor. No, but it's dripping up. It's dripping up. Unless everyone's upside down. Wait. If the moon was to get close to the earth, am I being dumb here? Correct me, and the scientists in the chat, correct me for this, but wouldn't the gravity be slightly altered if the moon came close to the earth? Slightly, the gravitational field. Or am I being dumb? Like, someone correct me if I'm wrong here. Now, I know the moon's going to crash into us, but like, I mean like, yeah, the tides will be fucked, but not enough to make things go upside down. It would need to get really close. If it was that bad, you would be seconds away from crashing. But then again, the moon, like, because I was thinking about it, wouldn't, if the moon gets closer, it was not going to crash into the earth, but it's going to be very close based on everything that's happened so far, especially in Show for Children. But you know what? I think I'm reading too much into just this one thing. I'm reading too much into it. I was just like, why is it doing that? I didn't notice that. Oh, something I missed. Look. I didn't notice that when I watched it. I should have. How did I not see that? There. The moon's in the gray frame. It's been watching the whole time. I swear to God, was that actually there in the original? Was that there in the original? I don't remember seeing that there. Yeah, that's the moon. That is the moon, because it's the same. It's just this mirrored. It's this mirrored, but it's in the distance. Like, how did the moon get there? And it's blinking as well. It's actively looking. Like, it's blinking too. So it, I guess it's actively looking around. Oh my God, those images. Oh my God. I don't know whether Ramsey's still here. Ramsey, AKA not the bees. Look, if you go to a look back, this guy. This guy's in a look back. If you guys don't know, we'll get to it. We will get to it, but pay close attention to this guy. Pay very, very, very close attention to that guy, because we may be seeing him again. I hope you're making notes, by the way. But yeah, it's very, very important. Very important that you remember him.
Your destination has moved.
Don't touch that dial now, we're just getting started. Oh God, yep. And there it is. That was just a quick look back. Wait. There was nothing else there. All right, we got three more. Let's go to real sleep. Real sleep is like an interesting one, but I don't think there's much that we can really say that isn't already been said. So let's just go watch it. And I'm going to ruin it for you guys. I'm going to ruin it for you guys. Real sleep? Real? Also, notice, this is an older Local 58 logo. This is an older Local 58 logo, so we're back. I think we're back in, what era is this? This video cassette. Whoa! Let me go read that one. What did that one say? What did that one say? This video cassette is non-transferable. It's intended solely for the personal use of Philip Gerhardt, ID 75117. Make notes of this as well, chat. Try. Oh yeah, thought research initiative. Also make notes of that as well. We will need this when we go to solve the ARG. Real sleep. 1983. All right, so 1983. Section one, myth versus fact. Turn to page 7 in your workbook. Myth or fact, dreaming is necessary for regular sleep function. Myth or fact, chat. You idiot, it's a myth. It's like I tried to debate you guys into saying you idiots, a goddamn myth. I don't have the textbook. While dreaming can occur, myth or fact, dreams contain symbolism that can predict the future. You goddamn idiot, is also a myth. It's like every time it goes red, you just go there and you're like, no, it's not a myth, it's not a fact, it's a myth. It's a myth in my world, it's a goddamn myth! It's a MACT. It's a MACT. Alright. Sleep allows the body and mind to heal and recover. Myth or fact? Eight hours of sleep per night is beneficial for both the body and the mind. However, these benefits are greatly diminished by the frantic, nonsensical images and auditory hallucinations we call dreaming. Dreaming, wait.
Dreaming is the vestige of a primitive mind.
The Kleitman map. Guys, turn to page 9 in your notebook. Turn to
page 9 in your notebook.
Our studies have allowed us to zero in on the neural pathways that dreams exploit in the subconscious mind. A Kleitman map is an index of electric activity in a brain burdened by dream stimuli. Once mapped, this activity can be triggered by other controlled stimuli, including via the visual cortex. Oh, why is it glitching? The opposite effects can be induced by using the inverse of the Kleitman map. I didn't get the book. Copy from someone next to you. I don't mind. Listen. Copy from someone next to you. No more dreaming. This is what restful, real sleep looks like. Inducing your anti-dream. All right, close the workbooks. Watch the screen now. Watch the screen. No more workbooks. Put it away. No two minds are alike. This instructional video was customized for you using the personalized climber map from your week 6 sleep session. Sequence 1, visual calibration. Stare directly at the center of your television. Stare at the center. Yeah. Yeah. Oh yeah. I love that face. Wait, why does it look like the buck to like Manny from Diary of Wimpy Kid? All right, cortical memory. We're doing that again. Also, this is like the thing. If you don't know already, people used to do this all the time back in the day in like the early meme community with like the troll face, where it was like, look at this, stare at this dot with the picture of the troll face, and then the troll will appear in your room, everywhere. All right. Oh no, they're merging! The merging has become a super being. Oh, you can see like the after image. All right, sequence 3. Listen to the phrase and repeat aloud. You guys already know what time it is. You guys already know what time it is. Let's hope I saved it. All right, you guys ready? You guys ready? You guys already know what time it is. All right, wait, am I being scanned? All right, I'll scan first. All right. We're scanning. All right, here we go. Let me show you how to scratch it. Let me show you how to scratch it. It's so, I don't know. I feel like Chris Traub timed it. I feel like he timed it, because there's no way There's no way that was unintentional. That was unintentional. That has to be intentional. Like, it works so well. It's so good.
Let me show you how to scratch it.
All right. There we go. So now that you've heard that one, let's go back to the super scary one. I hope you have your diapers in check. Like, it literally does it. It's like, let me show you how to scratch it. Like, it's not even scary anymore. It's just doing the thing. You just think of Thanos beatboxing. I mean, there is a face right there. Ugh. Why does it look like the eel emote? Sequence 4, acceptance. Read each phrase without reading. All right, here we go. We're gonna have to go through reading through all of these. All right, here we go. Also, the face stays there. All right, you guys ready? Oh, it looks like Tank Man. All right, here we go. Only the awake may think. Seeing is for open eyes. Cognition is a lie. I dream the world awake. Why does it look like Pepe now? I don't see it. There are no faces. Dreaming is a vestige. Sleep is pretend. A dream is a cowardly thought. Sleep is not civilized. The mind is a tyrant. This is your time now. I will never dream again. Stay out of your bedroom. There is work to be done. Dreams are just screaming with pictures. The pure of mind do not slumber. No good thought follows instinct. And the lack of sleep. The lie of sleep seeks many vessels. We are our own gods. Let cognizance nourish itself. Logic is the final burden. The primitive mind deserves its nightmares. No sleeping, guys. You better not be sleeping. This entire thing's basically just saying sleep is for the weak. Sleep is for the weak. When we sleep, we die. That's just a lie. I am an idea thinking itself. They are not faces. The subconscious is a parasite. Dreaming is a cancer on the face of sleep. They follow. What was that one? I love how it does it through the heartbeat. And it goes through like a heartbeat. Well, good night, guys. Yeah, good night. You can read the real sleep program. Yeah, a round of applause in the chat. Pog in the chat. Can we get a Thaf Pog? Thaf Pog in the chat. Some Pagmans in the chat. Must consult your technician if you're experiencing delayed results and or unwanted side effects. Do not see a doctor. Interesting that it doesn't want us to see a doctor after all of this. You can see the face. There, look. You can see the face. You can see a bit of it. There. I don't know whether you can notice it. The eye from the there are no faces thing. There. That's not a face. There are no faces. No, I see face. Oh, what do you mean? What's the countdown for? Oh yeah, that's just the end of the video. All right. The next one on the list is skywatching. Now, pay attention in general to like what we've done so far. I hope you've kind of remembered in general what we've gone so far, because we haven't even got to the ARG part yet. And that's the part I'm most hyped for, because I can't wait to show you it. Anyway, skywatching it is. And we got a new logo tonight. Skywatching at midnight, city council meeting, and then paid programming. Oh, why did the logo just show up for a bit at the bottom? I wonder why. Skywatching. Oh, wow. Now it's a shitty logo. It was such a good logo, and they changed it to a shitty logo. Like, look at that. That's so cool. And they just went... For what purpose? Literally, what purpose? Minimalism is what's killing creativity. Anyway, let's just go look around.
Yeah, those three dots look amazing. Yeah. Yeah, I can touch them. I can touch them. Those three dots look... Yeah, Orion's belt.
Who has belts in current year? Who has belts? Also... Belts are stupid. Yeah, bro, just get pants that fit. Alright, what's this? Pleiades. Ah, the moon. Here we go. So, we meet again. Well, we meet again, moon, if that's what you really are. Oh, we're going closer. Why are we going closer? Was that face in the clouds? I don't think there was. Let me look closer. Let me do that again. I see what you're saying, but I think that you may be deeping it too much. It's just the moon. Oh God, flashbang! You gotta put that down. Ow! There we go. Now you got details in on the moon. My throne? Throne? It's for me? Throne? It's for me? Alright, let's get closer. And all of this is definitely not supposed to be there. It's not supposed to be there. The moon should not be alive. Give Thaf his throne. Yeah, give me my throne. I want it. Why is it all fleshy and stuff? Like, ew! Oh God, look at it. It's all fleshy and stuff. Ew! I don't like that. Why is it all like, there's so much cheese. But there's so much cheese. Don't worry. It's just cheese. We're gonna get a slice from it very soon. That's why Cadaver is like in on it. It's just the affinity for cheese. That's what the moon's all about. The cheese has gone all moldy. I don't think so. I think the cheese is still fine. I like how we're getting closer and closer, and you can clearly see that this thing's alive. Wait, what is that? Why is that? Oh, what is that? That looks kind of, that looks, it's like, are you pointing at me? Why are you pointing? Oh, and it's gone. Why are you pointing at me? I'll point at you back. Wait, why are you pointing? Stop pointing. And now it's gone. The moon just disconnected. Oh God, oh! Oh, that is bright. Ah. That is way too close. That is way too close for comfort. Whoa. I didn't know you wanted to say hi. It seems like he's been indoctrinated by the moon. Yeah. Rejoice. Yeah, that's a person. And that's it. Whoa, that was quick. The Civil Broadcasting Authority. Make a note of this. Civil Broadcasting Authority. And that was it. So now after that, there was a year break. There was a year long break from Local 58. And it was all like, you know, it was all like, what's Local 58 going to do? until their latest upload. Until their latest upload. Now, I'm going to now play you the latest upload, and then we're going to commence trying to solve the ARG, because there's been so much that I've been doing behind the scenes while I was working on my main channel video. There's so much I've been doing behind the scenes about the local 58 ARG. But before we do that, I need to quickly get a drink, and we're going to bump the stream. So unfortunately, we're going to do one very quick ad time before I start the latest one and we go over the ARG. I will see you guys when the ad's done.
Are you sitting comfortably? Enjoying the stream, maybe? Do you want more content while being able to support the streamer in question? Well, why don't I introduce you to Twitch Prime? Or subscribing, whichever works. By subscribing to this channel, you directly support me and the content I'm trying to make. Whether it be pretending to be scared by Random Horror Game 483. Or maybe losing my mind at just another rage game that I've found from the dark depths of Steam. Subscribing allows me to put more budget and effort into the things you love to see week in and week out. If you subscribe, you get a fancy little icon next to your name that you can flex to others about how cool you are. The longer you're subscribed, the cooler your icon gets. And that's not all. Twitch subscribers get access to a super secret chat in my Discord server where you can chat with fellow rich kids.
Wait, hang on. Are you serious? This wasn't part of the script.
Fellow patrons, and suggest games for me to play and things for me to watch. You can also chat to me after streams for exclusive looks at new videos. But wait! There's more! Each week, I also have movie nights where we watch the latest and greatest films as well as some classics. So what are you waiting for? Go and subscribe, or use your Twitch Prime to get a free subscription. And now back to whatever it is we were doing.
And we are back! And we are back. We have returned. And are you guys ready for the latest upload? Like, are you guys ready? So first and foremost, I'm going to play you the entirety of the upload before we start taking it apart, because some people probably haven't seen it. So let's just go for it. I'll play the whole upload without stopping. I'm just going to show the whole thing.
Very same house, very same room.
Ten seconds. Nine. 8, 7, 6, I look at shit. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. There we go. I was waiting for it. Happy New Year! Oh, my ears. It's very good. This is great. Sorry, I'm trying to be as silent as possible. There we go. And that is it. That's it. That is it. Okay, so it's time to go over everything as thorough as possible. So everyone's gonna ask about the face and everything. Okay. So let's begin with, you gotta take out your notes because this is based on stuff we've done before. I'm gonna have to go consult another thing as well while I'm at it. So first and foremost, the most important thing is that it's a switch from analog to digital. Now you won't believe this, but me and Kazu were talking about potentially making or doing like an ARG VHS edit of the switch from analog to digital, because we in the UK, well for me in the UK, we basically made the switch from analog to digital. It was called the analog switchover and the digital takeover. We made that change in 2012. Now, one thing I always found interesting about the analog to digital switchover is what our TV channels did in the UK. Now I'll show you what they did in the UK. The digital, analog switchover. All right, here you go. Just give me a second because I have to like load another video. Okay, but essentially, In this is the one in Northern Ireland, but this is essentially what they did here. So at the end of the show, this happened.
This is BBC One Northern Ireland, where programs will
the digital switchover. So essentially, imagine seeing this at 1 a.m. in the morning. Like, what, 1 a.m. in the morning, it just shows this and this creepy little robot. You're just like, what the fuck? Who are you people? And why did you just do this? Like, I don't know why my screen just darkened like that. Bro, I don't think you guys just missed what happened on my screen. It got really dark and everything. Like, it was very cursed. But yeah, pretty much the analog kind of just, you know, left. It kind of just left the public eye because, you know, it's not cost effective to keep analog content running. So they ended up shutting it down. This was like the last one in Northern Ireland
since the days of Baird and Marconi.
Yeah. So basically, this is what they did in the UK. Like they shut it down and they pulled the plug like live. With the plushie of the mascot that they're using for the digital switchover. Now, Local 58 are doing the same thing. And they're saying that they're making the switch to digital from analog. And I think what the first link to everything is that if you notice, there was no outro at the end of the video. There was no outro crediting Chris Straub at all. So the switch to digital, I feel that the switch to digital is also heralding a new age where Local 58 itself is not going to break character. Like, it's not going to break character. It's not going to switch or anything. So this is what I ended up, like finding out. So first and foremost,
same room.
This show. Now this right here is an actual show. I need to remember the name of it. It's similar to Twilight Zone.
Dead men do tell tales. Will she try to explain it at all?
Now remember this guy? Remember this guy from the other from Fred Loud that appeared on the look back? One Step Beyond. Thank you, Ramsey. One Step Beyond. But yeah, remember this guy from earlier in A Look Back?
That I would like to hear, because I can't explain it. But it happened just the same.
Now, very important. Very, very important here. Directed by John Newman. That's actually not the person's name. That's not the director's name. Now, Ramsey did some looking. We both did some digging, and we found the actual episode that this is based on. Like the actual episode it's based on. Let me just quickly get it. What episode number was it? It was John Newland's, right? It was called One Step Beyond Director. See, the director of One Step Beyond is called John Newland. His name is John Newland. That's his actual name. And it was season 1, episode 4. He changed the name to John. So in Local 58, they changed the name to John Newmond. And Newmond means new moon in German. In German, Newmond means Neumond. I think it's Neumond means new moon in German. So that's the first like breadcrumb that was left. So after that had finished, we get blessed with a brand new logo for Local 58. Like, look at that. It's a look back. This is like another rebooted look back on everything. Goodbye Analog. In accordance with the FCG regulations. Now, this is in-universe. This is an in-universe parody of the FCC. Won't let me see and let me be me. So let me see. Anyway, why did I go on that tangent? But anyway, the FCG is basically the FCC, but in universe for Local 58. Because, you know, I don't like, honestly, I don't think anyone's going to, I don't think he wants to get any legal things happening with the FCC. And it says, starting tonight on July 13th, 2021, remember this date. Remember this date, July 13th, 2021. Because we're going to have to do digging outside of the video in a second. All the sets will experience an interruption in service. So already we can tell that this broadcast right here, this one right now, is on an old set based on what happens later on in the video. Need assistance? Analog TV. Now this is the important part before we continue. This is extremely important. Analog TV owners may qualify to receive a free digital conversion kit. For more information, call the number or go to the website. Now, you can actually call the number. You can actually go and ring the number, like right now. If you're in America, this number actually works. But don't worry, don't waste your time with calling the number, because I have the recording. I have the recording of what happens when you call that number. I'll show you, but warning, just a quick warning that it is loud. It is loud, so put your volume down, I'll warn you. But this is the audio that happens when you call that number. That right there. That right there. If you didn't notice, that's standard fax, but you can hear something in the background. You can hear something in the background. Like, listen very, very closely. Now, you can hear, so I already did a couple of things before I checked on the audio. There is Morse code in the beginning of the call. That Morse code, I translate, well, it's already been translated, but the Morse code goes and says, there are more receivers. The Morse code translates to, there are more receivers. So already it's another reference to what they said in the station ID when they said there are more receivers. So that means there's more than one network, there's more than one channel that is being targeted here. Apart from that, I've already tried and put the image through. I've already tried and put the audio through a spectrogram, returned nothing. It was just standard stuff. The spectrogram returned nothing. So there's no spectrogram like fuckery on this one, unfortunately. It's just something that's standard. But the important thing is the Morse code at the very beginning that says that there are more receivers in general. So that's the first breadcrumb from the phone call. Now, the website is a different monster altogether. local58.tv/digital. Now, if you go onto local58.tv right now, it's just a black page, just a blank page with just the video in the middle, like the latest one, the digital switchover. Before that, though, it had an official site for everything and stuff. But the important thing here is if you inspect element the site. By inspect elementing the site, you will notice right here. I don't think I can zoom this in, but right here, it says 2020. This has been commented out of the code. It says 2021 Thought Research Initiative LLC. Remember Thought Research Initiative from Real Sleep? It seems like this site, the digital switchover, is being run by the Thought Research Initiative. This is not in the regular code. This has been commented out, meaning that you won't see this on the site. Normally, you'd have a copyright at the bottom of the site saying all rights reserved to like the copyright owner. But this is on the local58.tv. The first another breadcrumb is that it's by the Thought Research Initiative LLC. That's one piece of information here.
Six down, six to go, then however many more from there.
Thank you, Advanta, for the sub.
Made the site basic because they realized the work MatPat did on the FNAF website.
MatPat didn't do any work on the website. It was his editors anyway. And also, everyone does this. It's standard ARG stuff. God damn it! Anyway, thank you for the sub, Advanta. But yeah, now if you go to local58.tv/digital, you get this. And something's changed here. Something has changed. Interesting. Something's changed here already from last time. But anyway, if you go into the site, you see a fake Wayback Machine. Instead of... Interesting. Yeah, something's changed. I'm going to go down it slowly. If you go to local58.tv/digital, first and foremost, the site changes. The URL changes to web 2021-2406. Now, it seems like they've corrected it because before it used to say July 13th, I believe. This used to say July 13th. I think he corrected the site to make it say the correct date, the 24th of June. I don't know the significance of the 24th of June, but I'm interested to see where it goes. Now, it says right here, are you ready to make the switch to digital? On July the 13th, 2021, Local 58 will join stations nationwide and broadcast using the DTV digital standard. If you have an analog TV set, you'll need to set up a digital converter box to make this compatible. Now, notice how it's in quotes to make the switch to digital. Like, we're switching to digital. And if you go to the site here, it's just gone all glitchy. It's glitching. Like, what is all of this? All of this is just glitches and everything. Like, what am I meant to see here? You see a bunch of other stuff. I took over that kind of stuff. And what is this? But like, the site's really, really fucky wucky right now. But let's also look at this let's look at this slowly. Now that number, look, actually, whoa, I didn't notice this. Don't have a digital receiver? Check your eligibility for a free digital conversion kit at many electronics retailers or by calling this number. That number is what gives you the Morse code. Even if you don't qualify or just miss the availability window, don't worry. There are other receivers. Another arc word. Like, what's up with this word? What's up with this term? There are other receivers. What does this mean? Because they've said this in the state. They said this in the look back. Or was it the station ID? I think it was the station ID. They said this there. And they said this in Morse code. And it gets even deeper than that. Because this is an image. This right here is an image. If I was to open the image in a new tab, the file name is called thereareotherreceivers.jpg. The file name is called thereareotherreceivers.jpg. Also, notice how this bottom thing kind of looks like a bit like a hand. I don't think there's anything more that I can say about that, but it looks like a hand. But all of these glitches are very interesting because there are different logos and stuff that have been hidden. For example, right here. Paid programming. This is the typical Local 58 countdown thing that they do almost all the time. Like the paid programming and then whatever show that they have before it gets to it. Now, this right here. This right here is what I'm interested in. Right here. Everyone's saying it says Civic something agency. But remember the CBA that we looked at before. Like, I'll go, you know what? We're gonna have to bring in the big dogs here. I'm opening Photoshop. We're bringing the big dogs here. We're bringing the big dogs here. I'm gonna show you a bunch of stuff. This is now the part where I have to get all technical and stuff. We're gonna get super duper technical, and you guys are gonna love it. We're just gonna wait until it loads. Cause I think the best course of action is to just look at what each of these images mean. So let me just quickly do this. Come on, load. We now have the image in Photoshop. I have the image in Photoshop. Now there's a bunch of things that we can decipher from the image from the get-go. Now the very first thing is right over here. Loads of people didn't know what this meant. Loads of people were very confused. It was like, what does this mean? You can vaguely see immediately, and you can see ER or something. ER immediately. But if we go into Photoshop right here, and then we do this, I think we take this, we put the curves down. And then we do this. And then we're going to go through the threshold. It's either that or the threshold. Let me just see. No, we're not going to use a threshold. It's something else. We need to use levels, I think. There. Now, I did a couple of photoshopping, and I have a feeling. I have a funny feeling that this right here, it says connect your receiver immediately. I think it says connect your receiver immediately or disconnect your server a receiver immediately. Because the whole point of the digital switchover is that it feels like Local 58 are trying to fight against the digital switchover. Like, I'll get a better Photoshop that I did earlier. I did a Photoshop earlier, but let me just get the font for you. Look, connect your receiver immediately. It's disconnect your receiver immediately. There. Here. If I put it directly underneath, I feel like it is. Yeah, I think it is. But I think it's disconnect. Yeah, look, because that's an S there. Wait, hang on. Disconnect your receiver immediately. There. Because it seems like the D... Look, this is... I don't know whether you can notice this well, but look. I'll try and draw it in, like, green. I'll draw in hack colors for you guys. I'm doing this on my other monitor, so I'll have to use my mouse for this, not my tablet. There. I will draw it in green just so we can. Come on. Why is it breaking on me? Oh, whoops. It opened on my other screen. That's why I was confused. All right. I see it there. I don't know about this. I think that's just a glitch. I think the C in front is a glitch, but this is what I see. This. So it does make sense. Disconnect your receiver immediately. So that's one of the biggest things to take from that specific Local 58 episode, because they're talking about the fact that there are other receivers, and this image is called "There Are Other Receiver." So I have a feeling is that what I think is that Local 58 know that they've been compromised. I have a feeling that Local 58 know that they're being compromised here. So they're trying to disguise the warning by saying that there are other receivers. You should disconnect your receiver immediately because of the digital switchover. I feel like it's the cult surrounding the moon is what's angry about it. Because again, if we go back, we're going to quickly go back to the, video. Let me just quickly go back to the video itself. But if we go here, so it's going to show the recap and everything. But look, did you see that? It already started. They already started fighting back against it. The glitch right here. The old logo is still there. You can see it, the old logo is still there. They're fighting it. And also that just popped up. This right here, if I try and go back, I'm going to scroll back here. We're going to have to be really quick with this. This. DTT announced graphics package 4x3, Prism Media Acquisitions, Affiliates, Local 58, Runtime, 060, 1080p, queue at 11:59. Let me just see if there's anything of note that I haven't missed. I have a feeling that there's something. Enhanced graphics package, 1159. Okay, that's there. But anyway, this kind of shows us the eras of Local 58, and it also gives us a date for when all the other Local 58, or the other Local 58 episodes came from. Because if you look at this right here, Local 58 had that. Now this. Look, this era of Local 58, remember, we had 1970, we had 1973 and 1975, which all used this logo. So that's already put, I think for perspective, that has put contingency through this era. And I think that's it. Then you've got 1979 all the way through 1988. That was that logo. So that one was Show for Children. And I think that one was it for then. Then for Skywatching, the logo that Local 58 are using for Skywatching is from 1990s. All the way up until 2003. Like the video. Oh, what the heck, I'll do it. I don't like the video. I commented on it, it's the least I can do. Anyway, this kind of puts into perspective that a look back, the station ID and weather service and what looks to be real sleep actually took place recently. Like Local 58 broadcast a 1983 recording in the 2000s. Why would you do that? I hope you guys have still got the notes, by the way. It's very important because there's a big rabbit hole that is also there. What year was fastest available route? That was 2014. Will this be on the final? It'll be on the exam. And then this is the new logo. Notice how the eight logo is like two circles like within like each other. I was like, is this some like moon kind of thing? I don't know. Anyway, the important part is this next part. There. Instantly. The digital switchover is happening. And you can see Local 58 show up. You can see the old logo show up right here. Look, it's shaking. It's shaking. Because they're fighting the switchover. It's like they don't want to switch because they know they're compromised. Switching to digital is going to doom everyone because it's a new form of exposure of what's been happening to a new generation of people. And Local 58 starts saying stuff about it. Like, look, it's right there. Announcement from Local 58. The station will not be participating in digital conversion at this time. Even though Local 58 is saying to do it, look. The station will not be participating. And now the digital thing has gone over. So yeah, the analog Local 58 are essentially the good guys here, is what I'm seeing. I think other people can probably get something different from it, but what I'm seeing is that Local 58, the analog Local 58, are trying to stop the spreading of the word of the moon, like what the moon's doing to people. And switching to digital is going to stifle their message because it just switches off. But I'm not too sure. I need to, maybe they are, maybe they aren't. I'd have to watch it over again. So Local 58, instead of saying announcement, it now says betrayal. It now says betrayal. I, the one you watched, I, the always here. They make you thought from pieces. They something, I don't know what that says. All knife. Thought shape and needles. They dream themselves a knife. So maybe. So I'm thinking about this because. So maybe from this, the analog. Yeah, maybe the moon is still stuck in analog. Because what throws me off is that the local58.tv website right now, the local 58 site, is run by Thought Research Initiative. And from Real Sleep, they were also part of the whole facade saying, like, you know, there are no faces, dreaming isn't real, you scream in your dreams, that kind of stuff. But why does it say betrayal? I feel like there must have been something there. Local 58 was meant to continuously push the message, and going digital means that they can't. It means that there's like a cutoff, because the people that were reaching, the people that Local 58 are trying to reach, are people that are still on analog. If that makes sense, like. People that are still on analog are the kind of people that they want to reach. Because you notice how none of the live action Local 58 videos, none of them were really urban. None of them were really urban. They were all rural. So I feel like the message of Local 58 was being spread on the analog networks, and by modernizing and going digital, that's already they can't, like, yeah, Richard, you made a good point. They can't, like, fuck with cable data, like satellite and airwaves. That's easy enough because you had the thing on Real Sleep, like they had the waveform that tells you whether you're actually sleeping or not, but you can't do that anymore with a digital signal as opposed to analog. Because it's a whole new signal that they have to get used to. Anyway, let's continue to see what they say. Oh, wait, there was something there. There's something there. County authorities. The emergency alert system issued. This is from Weather Service. This one's from Weather Service. And remember, from Weather Service, the moon kind of ended up winning. There was something that said through the window. All right, I'm going to go a bit. Hang on. All right, I'm going to do that again. Thoughts, they dream themselves a knife. I'm just making sure.
Let's go, BB.
Thank you for the whole. Oh, thank you, Alyssa Sunshine, for the 5 months. Where did you get the window line from? I come in through the window. They make you thought from pieces. They cut through the thoughts. I am all knife, all night. The betrayal. Okay, I had to make sure. I come in through the window. And the wording is still weird. So what are we saying? Because the wording seems really, really weird for what it's doing. And, I feel like that's the moon trying to communicate. Because remember, the moon, last we saw of the moon was Skywatching his throne and everything. And remember how what they were saying in Weather Report towards the end, at the end of Weather Report, the way they were speaking after the fact didn't seem right. And I think it means moonlight through the window, because remember, it said not to look at the light, not to look up, stay away from windows, stay out of your bedroom, that kind of stuff. And this is when, this is the broadcast from Weather Report. Go outside now. Go outside now. See, look. It's trying to fight it. So I think analog might be the bad thing. Yeah, no. Like the moonshine fire is saying, go outside now. Look, it's like, look at me. Look, is literally just out here. Imagine, just walk outside. Just a massive moon. Just there. And it's just like, look at me. Look at me. Come on. What are you doing? What are you doing? Why are you modernizing? Why are you modernizing? Look at me right now. Right now. Right now. It's like, you should look at the moon. Now. And now the glitches start happening. The glitches start happening. And also, we should probably think about the areas that Local 58 are affecting. See, look. It's typing just as it typed in Weather Report. Unthinking, they move to cut his throat. His throne. So, got his throat. It's probably talking about, you know, whatever's inhabiting, whatever entity the moon's supposed to represent. I don't think there was anything on the glitch. I think that was the glitch of the logo still. Only to make 1,000 mouths. Only to make 1,000 mouths. If he is silenced, we will speak for... The cult's taken over. I guess, remember, they had like a couple of worshippers and skywatchers. The cult's speaking for him now. I'm kind of tired, so I'm ahead. I'll have fun. See you, Jed. Thanks for coming to the stream. Thanks for coming to the stream. See ya. But yeah. I think if it says we will speak for him. So that means, whatever the entity on the moon is doing, it was directly linked to the analog. It was directly linked to the fact that Local 58 was broadcast in analog. Signs and wonders flood our little sky. That's the stuff. No stars above us. Only eyes. Okay. Only eyes waiting to open. So it's like, I guess the stars are like, I'm thinking about, because if it's directly linked to skywatching, remember how skywatching, they had a bunch of different stars and constellations. Those constellations could actually be the same kind of entity that the moon contains. Those constellations from earlier, from skywatching. If they're saying that the stars are eyes waiting to open, it kind of makes sense saying that if the moon can't do it, then the stars will. I'm just saying it's waiting to open. And they're saying, wait. And the arc where there are other receivers. And then this face. This face is actually directly from what I can see, this is actually for this, that is from One Step Beyond, that face, from what I'm seeing. So maybe the sky is a whole hostile entity. And also, what if you notice, wait, look, notice how the face, the stars, the eyes look like the stars in the sky, and the face, is that like, look, is that the complete opposite of a German face? But yeah, these two eyes can be counted as stars, and they've just opened. And it's in the other receivers. So wouldn't there potentially be other channels? There'll potentially be other channels that they will try and target. Also, I think this one's like the opposite of a German face. Physics opening his mouth, but yeah. And then this shows up. Federal law imposes severe criminal, civil and criminal penalties for the unauthorized reception of analog frequencies formerly allocated to broadcast television. Unauthorized analog reception constitutes a felony with a maximum penalty up to 10 years and or 150k fine. Now remember contingency. If you guys remember from contingency, you know how everyone's in on it. It's not local, as they're saying, because look at the logos. Homeland Security, the Department of Homeland Security, and I think, and the FCG apparently, but if we're still on analog, then we're in trouble. What if there are already YouTube channels up that we have to find the other receivers? Maybe. I have a feeling that Chris Chubb's going to have other channels that this is on. Because if there's the other receivers, it's going to spread. The whole idea is that it spreads to other channels. But then if you look at this, if we go back to there are other receivers, look right here. The warning. It's the same screen. If I can't, I want to try and make it like more obvious, but look, the same screen, FCG, the three logos, but this time there's no text there. It just says to disconnect your receiver immediately. Like they're not even messing around here now. They're not even messing around. They're saying to disconnect the receiver immediately. But there are also other things on that website that are of note as well. I'll go to them now. But if you look closely at the website itself, if we scroll back to the top, there is a small peak here. The peak in 2017 is the YouTube link to the channel. There are two peaks in 2021. The main site are digital, but there's a peak in 1999. This peak in 1999 leads you to this. Right here. This. Oh god, I mean scanned! It leads you to this right here. Also, there's a new blip! Wait, what? The site just got updated! Wait. What's this? I believe this is the same. Wait, no, this is the same. This is the same. I've seen this before. Let me check Namco, one sec. I've seen this one before. But we'll get to that in a bit. We'll get to that one in a bit. There are two blips in 2001. So 109. Here, there, I got it. All right, the server counted an internal error or misconfiguration and was unable to complete your request. Please contact the server administrator and inform them of the time the error occurred. So that's like a standard thing. Now the server error log, 9th of January, 2001. Host trying to get index.html, append trailer report, error opening USR local 58 admin server 1, no such file and or directory permissions reset by host. So the also now they're trying to fight. Oh, and I knew it. Okay. Because the cache dates on January the 9th, 2001. Those are days of full moons. Okay. This makes a lot of sense. We're onto something here. Okay. So, essentially, these are all full moons, this is at a time where the moon has full control and people are indoctrinated to do the bidding of whatever entities on the moon, which includes taking control of Local 58 to spread the message. Because if there's one at the 3rd of November of 1999, there's the 404 page, which is the 17th of March 2001. And then the one on the 24th of June is the Strawberry Moon. The one that... Also, I was going to get to it, but here. This image right here is a vestigial low-band filter. Do you guys remember when they were talking about, like, vestige stuff in real sleep? Remember when they were talking about that stuff in real sleep? I ended up finding out that this image... You can throw it into Photoshop. You can throw this image into Photoshop. Let me just quickly, let me quickly initialize the image for you guys. Now, if I get the image right here, this is it in Photoshop. Now, watch this. It looks regular, right? It looks normal. It looks like something, it looks like a photocopy. But watch what I can now do. Watch what I can now do with, like, with Photoshop. You go here, and then you use the threshold. And then you slowly down, and then if you look at the whole image, if we down the threshold, there. Do you see it? Do you see it, guys? Right here. There's a QR code. There is a QR code. If you're down the threshold, it's not there. It's a QR code right here. Now I've scanned the QR code already. The QR code does work. I've scanned it. What's it called? When you use the when you scan the QR code, it says parasite, host, inhabitant, environment. I'll type it in. Scanning the QR code on your phone will get you, it will open your notes app and it will type this. It will type this right here. Like this environment. This is what it says. This basically, what this means is it's kind of a saying. It's a parasite to a host is like an inhabitant to its environment. That's basically what it's saying. So that being said, I think we're going to you know, I'm feeling like it's going to link in with Gemini somehow. Well, not Gemini, but you know, like the kind of vibes that Gemini is going for with like parasites and hosts and stuff. I don't think they're going to do doppelgangers or anything, but I think it feels like the moon's going to, because the moon kind of got people blindly following it. Like the moon, like in that video, the moon literally just says, blindly following, like people are going to go outside, blindly following whatever the thing is doing. So let me just let's go back. But that's the vestigial low band filter. What else did I get? I'm trying to see what else I can get from this. Clicking on any of these leads you to the same page, it seems. But let me try something. there. This is still run by the Thought Research Initiative. The Thought Research Initiative are still running all of this. Are they the parent company of Local 58? Maybe we should need to be looking more at the Thought Research Initiative. I gotta go to work now. Bye, Thaf, and hope the rest of the stream goes well. Thank you. Welcome online viewers. I'm just looking at some, all the peaks are very interesting. All your favorites not here. Look back. We can access it. Keep in mind, this is using internet lingo from 1999. Yeah. But Local 58 posted on their Instagram earlier. Local 58 posted on their Insta. I'm trying to... Instagram Local 58. Yep. Got it. There. Local 58. Here. Why did they post this? And why does it look like it's either like a scuffed Mickey Mouse like head or an upside down cock? Local 58 just posted a local, I think that's the face. Local 58 posted on their Instagram 6 hours ago. But yeah, I think if anything, is that image of the distorted German face? Oh yeah, there are no faces as well, because there was no faces on that on the digital switchover thing. What else? What other leads do I have? I don't have many, but those are like the big main ones. I'm interested to see what does this one mean? Wait, what does? If I scroll up here, that's the emergency alert broadcast system. There's another QR code on the Era of Home recording image. Oh yeah, I already went through that one. I went through that one. That one, I believe. Let me go and get it. The blip in 2017 is just a link to the channel. Yeah, if you look closely at the Era of Home recording, let me just quickly get this real quick. Yeah, I see what you mean with the QR code, but the QR code for the Era of Home recording, let me just quickly get it for you guys so that you can see what I'm seeing as well. So I don't forget. If you look at the image closely, there's a QR code right here, like there. I don't know whether you guys can see it as well, but like right there. There's a QR code there. Scanning that QR code gives you the phrase, "A predator cannot differentiate prey from accomplice." That's it. That's all it says. I'm just waiting. What else? What's going on? You doing big brain time? Yes. It seems like there's another one on the TV on the left. Nope. I already went through that one on Photoshop. I don't think there is. The worshippers may mean nothing to the moon. Yeah. That's what I'm thinking. Now, I thought that the glitch on the digital page was a result of, I assumed the digital page, this right here, I thought this was edited on a text editor, but apparently it isn't. It's just Photoshop. But in terms of things so far, I don't think anything. That's what I have so far. That's what I have so far. In terms of local 58 stuff. Why is the blip for 2021 like slightly elevated here? Like why is that elevated? I can't be the, am I the only one that sees this? Wait. Look, is this an error? This looks like an error. But yeah, I feel like that's all that we can get. I feel like that's all we can get for this ARG. I think if I post this on Thaf VODS tonight, I'm gonna post it on Thaf VODS tonight and see what people say. I think that's the best course of action. But that's what I got so far. What do you think? Like that's literally unironically, like that's what I got. How did I do? What were we saying? I can't wait for more, honestly. But I'll let you guys know when I receive more. I noticed something on the video, four-way dirt path to me on the very first few frames. Let me just quickly go. I don't see it. I get what you mean. All right. Oh, gosh. That was a good one. I won't lie, lads. That was a good one. All right. Should we call it time? I think we should call it time. Let's call it time. That was a good one. Guys. Will you be in the VC after this? I do have to finish my main channel video. So I'm going to get some more recording of the main channel video done. I want to have it out on Friday, like I promised. If not Friday, on Saturday. But I want it. It's definitely going to be out this week. It's definitely, for sure, going to be out this week. I am too close to the end for it to not be out this week. So, yes, tell your friends. Tell your family. Tell your friends. Tell your doctor about it. New Thaf 9 video. New main channel video. On Friday or Saturday. But now let's go on Twitch. But for now, let's go see who's live on Twitch, and let's see who we can raid. Let's see who we can raid here. I think. Oh, Shmi's live. Shmi is live. Oh my god, Shmi's wet. Oh my god, Shmi's got a drip. What should we do with a drip? Oh, Mary's on the stream as well. Oh, what should we do with the drip? All right. I hope you guys enjoyed your stay. I think it's time to initiate a raid on Shme. I want you guys to spam Shmi's chat and say he's bad at video games. Say he's bad at video games. He said like good drip. Say good drip, bad player or something like that. But tell him he's bad at video games. But anyway, thank you guys so much for watching this stream. I'll get this on Thaf VODS as soon as I can. I'll probably get it tonight, actually. And I will see you guys in the next one. I may take some days off to finish the video, just to let you guys know as a quick warning. But apart from that, thank you guys so much for watching the stream. I will see you guys in the next one. Bye-bye!